Happy Lord's Night. God bless you guys for tuning in to the Kingdom of God Radio Hour Internet Program.
Amen.
I'm Joshua. We got here Wally. Got here Alex. I'm going to follow Justin. Before we start, I wanted to read something that's found in Matthew 6. It's been on my heart all day. I don't know why this scripture has been on my heart, but I pray that it would be a blessing to you, listener.
Amen.
As it was to me. Matthew 6, 25. Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they?
Amen.
Can any one of you be by worrying add a single hour to your life? And why do you worry about clothes? See how the flowers of the field grow? They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you that not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? So do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them. But seek first his kingdom.
Amen.
And his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. So today, as I was reading the scripture, guys, God spoke to me and said, there's no reason to worry about what you're going to wear, what you're going to drink, what you're going to eat. I know your needs.
Amen.
I know your needs. So just worship me in spirit and truth, and God and I will provide these things unto you.
Amen. Amen.
So I hope this scripture, this passage was a blessing to you. Whatever you're going through today, remember, God's there. God is on your side. God is there to help you through this storm, this
Amen.
Fire, this situation that you have come across. And before you know it, you'll be out of it. Like it says over here, God feeds the birds of the air. He takes care of the animals of this earth. How much more are you important?
Amen.
You're much more important to them.
Amen.
He cares for you just as much as he cares for those birds in the air.
Amen.
Let us open up in prayer that God would use us, the boys here tonight. Pray with us as we pray for you guys, your listeners. In Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, Devila, we acknowledge you, Devila, for who you are, Devila. King of kings and Lord of lords, Devila, our provider, Devila, our shelter from the rain, Devila, our peace, Devila, our comforter, Father God. I thank you, Lord, Father God, for all the things you have done for us, Lord, and are about to do in our lives, Lord, Father God.
Jesus.
Lord, Father God, I pray for the listeners at that, Devila, that you would speak, Devila, through us to them, Devila. That you would use us, Devila, as vessels, Devila, for your glory, Devila. Lord, Father God, I pray for Alex, Devila, who brings forth your word, Devila, that he would bring in, Devila, boldness, Devila.
Thank you. Lord.
That you would hide him behind your cross, Devila,
yes,
that whatever
Lord, Jesus,
words come out of your mouth, Devila, may he come directly from you, Lord Jesus. Lord, Father God, I pray for the listeners that I had, Devila, that you would bless them, Devila, as they listen, Devila, that you would encourage them, Devila, that you would teach them, Devila, how to worship, Devila.
Amen.
Lord, Father God, because we don't know how to worship, Lord, Father God.
Yes,
we need more of you, Devila.
Thank
we
you,
need more Jesus. Of you, Lord Jesus. Lord, Father God, I pray, Father God, for tomorrow, Devila, that your service will be blessed, Father God, that you bless, Father God,
Jesus,
your people, Devila,
name.
That they would be encouraged at that, Devila, listening, Devila, that they would want it, Devila, that they have a zeal, Devila, to go to your church tomorrow, Devila, your house, Devila, to worship you, Devila, praise you, Devila, in spirit and truth. Devila.
Thank you, Lord.
Worship you, Jesus.
Just them like your body more. In tu sano amberato, sane chachi orba, o pai giulito. Adi, ai, re.
Bye.
worship you, Devil. Praise your holy name. Worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're worthy. You are worthy to be praised. Chaches, Devil. God bless you. Amado Pablo Alex has a, I was reading up today, he sent me an email of what he's going to be sharing about. And as I was reading this, I knew it was directly from God. And the way it blessed me today as I was reading and studying with him, I pray that it would bless you at that.
Amen.
I know Alex is a blessed man of God. His family's blessed. I'm on Apollo Wally and Justin. They're blessed men of God. And I know God's going to use us tonight for his glory. Not Amen. For us, but for his glory.
Amen.
We worship and praise your holy name.
Amen. Before Jazangli, we'd like to give out our telephone number. It is area code 954-990-0036. That's area code 954-990-0036. We do have a couple announcements before Jazangli. Kataramari Kangari, Kaisam Kateano, Miami. Our church is located at 7200 Davie Road Extension. That is in Davie, Hollywood, Florida. Our church service starts tomorrow at 4 o'clock, 4 p.m. tomorrow, every Sunday. Our Tuesday men's Bible study starts around 10 o'clock. Our Thursday night worship service is around 9:30, 10 o'clock. The church do invite you, one and all, to come and worship and praise our God. Amen?
Amen. Hallelujah.
If you didn't catch some of that, we're probably going to mention it a few hundred times tonight.
Exactly.
So you will catch it sooner or later in the program. I just wanted to encourage everybody to call in. It's very important to call
Amen.
In, the identical testimony, to pray. If God puts it upon your heart to pray for someone, we all have prayers. And
Amen.
What more than to call in and pray with somebody who wants to pray with you? We're here. We want to pray with you. It says in the Bible that where two or three are gathered, there he is in the midst of them.
Thank you, Lord.
So we want to agree with you in prayer. It's more powerful. Your prayer works on your own.
That's right.
But it's more powerful to pray with others.
And that's right.
We want to encourage you guys to call in. Again, the telephone number 954-990-0036. Call in. Give a testimony. Let somebody know that we're on the air.
Amen.
They can go to miamichurchggcc.com. You might have clicked on, you know, one of the boys' bio on Instagram to find us easy. But it might not be that easy for the person you're telling to get true to us. So you might want to tell them to go to miamichurchggcc.com, click on the link, and it should take you directly to the live feed. You guys have any prayer requests? I have a prayer request, Alex.
Amen.
Ollie.
Amen.
My Uncle Frankie and his family is coming in town tonight.
Okay.
Some of the family's driving down. I pray that God would bless their plans here.
Amen.
That God would
Amen.
Use them here. That God would not only bless them here, but heal my cousin Ricky.
Amen.
Amen.
And they're here.
Amen.
And would you bring that up in prayer?
Yes.
That God would?
Amen.
Hallelujah, Mugadil Mugadad.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, we come before you tonight, Mugadad. Lord, and we lift up Uncle Frankie and his family
yes,
in
Lord,
prayer,
yes.
Mugadad. Lord, I pray that you bless them while they're here, Mugadil. They're a blessed family, Mugadad.
Yes, Mugadad.
And we pray, Mugadad, that you would meet all their needs, Father. Whatever they need, Mugadad. Whatever they're praying for, Mugadad. Lord, that you would bless them with it, Mugadil.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we pray for Ricky, Mugadad. Lord, sustenance,
yes,
Mugadad, from the top of his head to the soles of his feet, Mugadad.
Christ Jesus.
A complete healing, Pedestim, Mugadad. And Lord, for him to give you all the glory, Mugadad,
yes,
all the honor and praise, Mugadad, all the days of his life, Mugadad.
Thank you, Lord.
Never to forget, Mugadad, what you've done for him,
Amen.
Mugadil.
Amen,
Amen,
Jesus.
Lord, now we thank you, Father, and we worship you, Mugadad. We know, Mugadad, because you are God of miracles, Mugadad,
Amen.
And you are going to do it, Mugadad. Now bless them, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus,
yes,
we
Lord.
Pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, Wally. God bless you. Alex, like I said earlier, I was reading up on what you had prepared for tonight, what God had gave you.
Amen.
And it was beautiful. Would you tell us what you're going to share about tonight?
Tonight, the title of the study is called Worship. Now, that's a very big part of a Christian's walk with
Amen.
Christ.
Very important.
Amen.
Very important.
Very important. We believe we do have a phone call, and we will go to that phone call right now. Kingdom of God, you are on the air.
God bless you guys. I need a prayer.
God bless you.
Who is this?
Kwansan.
Mesame Dinah in Houston, Texas.
Hello, Bibi Dinah. Satsan.
All right, Nirshala?
I'm good. How's everybody?
Good.
How's Frankie? How's the family?
Everybody's good, baby. Everybody's all good.
That's good. That's good. Thank
I
God.
Need a couple of prayers. One is for Alex.
Okay.
He's going to do surgery on his hip.
Okay.
And the second one is for our nation, guys. It's crazy
Amen.
What's going on into the world.
Amen. I agree.
Amen.
Is that it?
That's it, babe.
Okay. Alex, would you bring these prayers up?
Amen. Avente cu Gisami. Mugodel avasangla tute mugodel in Christ Jesus' name, Devla.
Yes, Lord.
Mugodel, we pray for Amaro Prao, Mugodel Kajal, Mugodel for surgery, Mugodel. Devla, we claim, Mugodel, Isaiah 53:5, Mugodel, it is by your stripes, Devla, that we are complete healed, Mugodel. Pala tu, Mugodel, del candante po kyo trayo, Mugodel, po trusul, Devla, kai shordi lo kiro rat, Mugodel, kai lan kur la virchi pe ke zeya, Mugodel, and agudyab, Mugodel, sama mesa stay, Mugodel, in Christ Jesus' name, Devla. Mugodel, taska ke alumnia, Mugodel, and latute, Mugodel, sat penya mani pay, Mugodel. Devla, have your way, Mugodel, not ours, Mugodel.
Amen.
Devla, we pray, Mugodel, that all people will get closer to you, Mugodel.
Yes, Lord.
We pray, Mugodel, that bondages would be broken, Mugodel. We pray, Mugodel, that you would just, Mugodel, be the Lord of our life, Mugodel. And Devla, have your way with your people, Mugodel.
Yes, Lord.
Mugodel, put your people back in church, Mugodel. Hallelujah, Avriandai Lumnia, Mugodel, in Christ Jesus' name, Devla. Devla, we just know, Mugodel, that tonight, Mugodel, Ashunesa Maro Hujimos, Mugodel, Sarsama Me Kate, Hujisa Me Tute, Mugodel, Devla, Mugodel, Sekafki Omuya Menga, Mugodel, Sterfiarpe Amende, Mugodel, Arat, Mugodel, in Christ Jesus' name, Devla, Pintele Ferestian Daugayo, Mugodel, and Ashuna Me, Mugodel, in Jesus' mighty name, Devla, we pray, Mugodel, for Amaripe Dina, Mugodel. Tazlanga tute, Mugodel. Bless her all the days of her life,
Amen.
Mugodel. Mugodel, sogodi silako gujimos, Mugodel. Tujanes lako ilo, Mugodel.
Amen.
Grant, Mugodel, her prayers in the name of Jesus,
yes,
Mugodel. We pray, Mugodel. Sastarimos, blosoimos,
yes,
pesala ki familia, Mugodel.
Yes, Lord.
In Christ Jesus' name, Devla, we pray prosperity, Mugodel, penindi. In Jesus' name, we pray, Mugodel.
Amen.
We give you all glory, Amen. Praise, and honor, and worship, Devla. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen. God bless you guys.
God
Keep
bless
up
you.
The good work.
God bless you, Bibi Dino.
Love you guys.
Love you too. As you were saying, Alex.
As I was saying, the title of tonight's service is called Worship. And it is a very, very, very important part of a Christian's life.
Amen.
Because of the reason why, Odel Kamil Amendar, worship.
Amen. Amen.
He looks for that. And they word about Penel on the scripture because he is seeking those who worship him earnestly.
Amen.
So on the kuja that, so the Lord blessed me with this last night as we were talking, me and you last night, Josh, and you wanted me to, the Lord put it upon your part that we can share tonight. And I thank the Lord because it is a blessing and an honor to serve him tonight. Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
So we want to thank the Lord and we want to open up in prayer.
Amen.
De lilo de lo prao.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, develop the karel peski woyarat, the national kanchi konik mandar, but the ashunele devlesarat. Amen.
Amen.
Aven kujisame. Mugodel, we put you before us, Mugodel, in Jesus' name, Devla. We put ourselves before you, Devla, Jesus. I Mugodel tazami kalikyo trusularat, Mugodel. Garavame palakyo trusularat, Mugodel. Devla Mugodel name kanchi te avil mandar Mugodel. Sam Mugodel te avil tutar Mugodel. Holy Spirit Mugodel, minister Mugodel as you ministered to me Mugodel, as you gave me this word Mugodel. Minister to your people tonight Mugodel. Pintarilinga kan Mugodel, kawralinga ile Mugodel, te ashunen ki worba rat Mugodel. In Jesus' mighty
yes,
name,
Lord.
Devla, bless us all with total spiritual wisdom
Amen.
And knowledge,
yes,
Mugodel.
Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, Devla. Dea make yo hararimos arat, Mugodel. In Christ Jesus' name, Devla. As we preach your word, Mugodel,
yes,
to your
Father
people,
God.
Mugodel, tonight,
yes,
Mugodel.
Sar
meklan tuo zarkono, Mugodel. Kai pindan kire jeninga to go out and preach your word, Mugodel. Arat, Mugodel. Use us, Mugodel, only for your glory,
Amen.
Mugodel.
Amen.
In Christ Jesus' name. Chisama me kanchi, Mugodel,
yes,
but tusan sako fialo arat. Mugodel haida, Mugodel, I swin so sad arat, Mugodel. Kongodia shunel, Mugodel, in Christ
yes,
Jesus'
Lord.
Name, Devla. Let them be blessed by you, Mugodel, and only you, Mugodel. Take over, Mugodel, for us arat, Mugodel, in Jesus' mighty name, Devla. We thank you, Mugodel, in Jesus' name. Amen,
amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Our first scripture that's going to be found in Deuteronomy chapter 12, verse 21, reading out of the Good News Bible, Ramul Gajan. If the one place of worship is too far away, then whenever you wish, you may kill any of the cattle or sheep that the Lord has given you. and you may eat the meat at home, as I told you. Hmm. Now, the Dumut Palpare, it wasn't that easy to worship God like we do today.
No, it wasn't.
It was a sacrifice mm-hmm. that had to be done before we can go in and worship God.
Amen.
Because there was the Ark of the Covenant and Nazo Cristo Pegajapuv, and everything had to be sacrificed to God before you can actually pray to Him and ask from Him anything or do anything of worship to Him.
Right. It was a preparation.
Yes.
It was had to be a preparation done before you would actually be able to worship.
Amen.
And not anybody could have worshiped. It had to be a special person.
That's right.
I believe it was a priest.
Yes. It had to be a priest.
Okay.
You know, an anointed priest that you would bring your sacrifice to.
Okay.
And it would be whatever it might be. It was a cow. It was a small lamb or whatever. And it had to be without blemishes, without spots. Nastia velas gudo bakro or gudo gudomni dukado dukadi in any way. It couldn't be sick cow or something like that. It had to be a perfect cow
right.
because you were offering perfect sacrifice to God, and God would not accept anything else but perfectness.
Look how important worship was
then. Amen.
And it's just as important it was then. It is 100%. Now today. You know, it wasn't, like you said earlier, it's not easy. It wasn't easy then to worship the Lord. It wasn't easy to do all these things to get prepared. It had to be in a special way.
And another thing was, it says in the first verse, if the place of worship is too far away. So that means that nas kangariang pesako kona kaisa katia na kakana ng pekako chaso. There wasn't churches that was kudo in every Romano city that you can think of. So there was churches that maybe you lived at 100 miles away back then, or 50 miles away. I nas mobilia. There was people used to ride donkeys and kudo by foot and whatever. So it was a major, major ordeal to do to worship God back then.
The word I was looking for is a Levite.
Yes. Amen. God bless you, Josh.
God bless you, Whitey. Whitey gave it. Whitey just texted
God bless
that.
You, Whitey. Appreciate that one. But we're going to see here in the second scripture.
Wait, I have something to share on that
Go
scripture
ahead.
That you
Go
had.
Go ahead.
It says, if the one place of worship is too far away, then whatever you wish, you may kill any of the cattle or sheep that the Lord has given you. We had a sacrifice that was greater than that.
Amen.
We had a sacrifice who was Jesus.
Amen.
And I thank God for Jesus, because we are able to worship anywhere now.
That's right.
It's not as difficult as it was back then.
Amen.
That sheep or that cattle was important then, but God has given us a bigger sacrifice that we was able to, able to worship God anywhere. I don't know if you're going to... Are you going to read about the Samaritan woman?
I don't think that was in here.
Okay, well, if you read the story about the Samaritan woman is telling Jesus, not knowing that he's the Messiah, that you have to be at a specific place
right.
to worship God. Right. Jesus, to that, there's going to be a time where you don't have to worship on this
That's
mountain
right.
or the next
Amen.
Mountain. You can worship God in your car.
Amen.
You can worship God anywhere you want
to,
anywhere
Jesus.
You're at. So thank you, Jesus, for that we're able to come to Him and worship anywhere we're at.
Amen. Josh, you told her, yet the time has now come.
Amen. Right. Amen. So the time is here. Thank the Lord.
Amen.
That we don't have to go through preparations to worship God. We can worship Sar Penel Maropralo Josh on the Mobilia, on a street corner, on the Marikara, Kai Godisam.
Wherever you're at.
Sai Pandavasa Maria Khan, Haivaza Zevas, Ailuadisa Maridevles.
Amen.
Amen.
That's spirit and truth. That's
Amen.
That's what God wants. He wants you to worship Him throughout your day.
Amen.
How many times have you guys been in the car and this radio might not be on, but you hear music.
That's right.
And you just start singing, and you just start worshiping, and you just start praying, and you just start talking
Amen.
To God. That's worship.
Amen.
That's
Amen.
Worship. That's what God wants you to do.
Amen.
And, they couldn't do that then.
That's right.
You know, they couldn't do that.
That's right.
So thank God that He made it easier for that it's easier for us to worship.
Amen. Moving on in the study, our second scripture is going to be found in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 28 and 29 out of the NIV. Ramogaja. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us be thankful and so worship Him, God, acceptably, with reverence and awe, for our God is a consuming fire.
Amen.
How big God is.
Amen. He is a consuming fire. God is pinalaming akate in a scripture. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom, this is because of avilo o Cristo pekajapuv. Todiales odil tradiales andaukayo pistar. Tradiales pekajapuv. To be the last living sacrifice.
Thank you, Lord.
For people to have freedom to worship God kai godi mangan whenever they want. It all it takes is to close your eyes, raise your hands, and worship God.
Look at the inheritance God has given us. We're receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken.
Amen.
There's people. People have. I don't know about kingdoms nowadays, but they have battle temples, things
right.
like that.
Right.
And an earthquake can destroy that.
That's right. Because
it
can only
be
a
destroyed.
Building.
It's only a building.
Amen.
Earthquakes, things like that can be destroyed. But God has given us something that cannot be destroyed.
Amen.
It's something that is great. And not only that, God is a consuming fire.
That's right.
Look at that. Look what God has given us.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. I believe we have a phone call.
Yes, we do.
Mom, you're on the air.
Hey, guys. God bless you.
God bless you, too.
I have a couple of prayers. I'm hoping you guys can keep this in prayer. There's a woman in New York. Her name is Sabrina. She's in a coma. And there's another Romney in Houston. Her name is Docha. She's married after Bonzo. And she's got blood clogs. Mm. And I told her daughter we'll keep her up in prayer. And I also want to pray for the young couples who are waiting to be blessed by the Lord with a family.
Amen.
Amen.
And I want to pray for traveling mercy upon Ronnie and Frankie.
Amen.
And a healing, a complete healing, because I believe God's going to do it.
Amen.
I believe the time has come for Amen. Ricky's healing.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And to pray for our church, our pastor, and to pray for you guys, that God keeps you strong and serving Him. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Mugodil, we come before you, Mugodil, Magdata, Mugodil, humbly, Mugodil, kai kiltrushula vas, Mugodil.
Yes.
Devla Jesus, Mugodil, taska kalima no shenangla tuti, Mugodil. Devla kudiagomni kai sende koma mugodel.
Yes, Lord.
Tu sai bushtaves mugodel.
Amen.
Numa trade ki worba mugodel andau gaio mugodel. Hai wei bushtel mugodel pakiro anav mugodel in Christ Jesus name,
yes.
Devla.
Yes.
Mugodel, we come before mugodel against blood clogs mugodel in the name of
yes,
Jesus
Lord.
Mugodel. We pray mugodel. Yes. We come against all sicknesses right now mugodel
yes,
kata kutem
yes,
mugodel. Devla mugodel kongodi shipila pekiro anav mugodel. Ashunle
yes.
mugodel hai azbale mugodel. Anzokyo vas Mugodel and Agayo Mugodel. I sastiali Mugodel in Christ Jesus' name, Devla. Magdata Anasli Rikis Anglatute Mugodel. For we know that we know that we know, Mugodel, that a total, complete healing, Mugodel, is upon him, Mugodel. Right now, Mugodel. Touch him, O Lord, in a mighty way, Mugodel. Right now, Kai Godia Vela Mugodel. Right now, Devla Jesus, we pray, Mugodel, in Jesus' mighty name, Devla. Because there is power in the name of Jesus. We pray, Mugodel, the name above all names, Mugodel. Touch him, Mugodel, and heal him completely, Mugodel. For he can be, Mugodel, a testimony, Anglatute, Mugodel. Kande Sakya Kangarea, Mugodel. Devla, Mugodel, we uplift the pasture, Mugodel, Anglatute, Mugodel. Devla Mugodel Dele Zor Mugodel spiritually and physically Mugodel for tomorrow Mugodel. Devla give him a word of encouragement, Mugodel Mugodel to share with your people, Mugodel, right now in the name of Jesus we pray. Mugodel, we want to thank you, Mugodel, for Gilda, Mugodel, for Miller, Mugodel, for Josh, Mugodel, for all their family, Mugodel, for they are a blessing unto you, Mugodel. Give them, Mugodel, prosperity, Mugodel, peace, Mugodel. Give them, Mugodil, in Jesus' name, sogori dabule, Mugodil, blessing, Mugodil, financially, Mugodil.
Yes,
in Jesus' mighty name, Devla, we want to thank you, Mugodil. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
God bless you guys.
God bless you too. Before Jazangle, we'd like to give our phone number out one more time. Area code 954-990-0036. If you do have any prayer, or if you know anybody that has a prayer that you need, that you can stand in for in an agreement, we'd love to hear from you tonight. Our money number is 954-990-0036.
Right, we only have one phone line, so yes. If you hear somebody on the air, please wait until they're finished, and we'll be able to take your call. Alex, I wanted to read a scripture. It's found in Psalms 105, amen, verse 1. And it shows how important it is to worship God. But before we read that, I wanted to give the definition. If you Google the definition of worship, it says, the feeling or expression,
yes,
of reverence and adoration for a deity. What that means is to adore somebody.
Amen.
To, respect somebody.
Amen.
To, just love that person. Mm. Not necessarily being, in a song. There's multiple ways to worship God.
Amen.
There's not only one way. The listener might think, well, I'm not on choir.
Right.
So how can I worship God?
Exactly. Right.
Or I'm not a pastor. Or I'm a teacher.
Right.
Or, servant in church in, amen, general.
Right.
How can I worship God, Wally? Well, there's a lot of ways to worship God. And I'll get to that a little bit later. I'm going to give, some other ways to worship God as we go through the study.
Amen.
But it's on my heart to read this scripture. It's found in Psalms 105, verse 1. It's the Amplified Bible. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his doing among the peoples. Sing to him and meditate and talk on his marvelous deeds and devoutly praise him. Glory in his name. Glory in his holy name. Let his heart of those rejoice and seek and require the Lord as their indispensable necessity. Now, I that's a big word. I didn't understand, yes, what that word meant, mm-hmm, until I did some research on it.
Okay.
It's indispensable, minope, very.
Right. Okay.
And necessity, it sounds like a big word, but we all know it. It's very necessary. It's very necessary to worship God.
Yes.
God requires that you worship him.
Mm-hmm.
If you call yourself a Christian, you should want to worship God,
amen,
all the time.
It should be something that comes natural to a Christian,
right,
because of the Holy Spirit that lives inside of,
right,
us now.
Right.
The Holy Spirit lives for one thing. And that is
God.
To worship,
amen,
God.
Amen.
So, amen. So, that's why, it should be natural for us to want to worship God. It shouldn't be hard for us to worship God. It shouldn't be pesalasa. I know that we are in this world, and everybody's got a problem, and there's the things of this world get to you sometimes, but that's when we have to slow down, close our eyes, give thanks to God and worship him for what he has done. And what he gave us was his son on the cross.
Right. Just giving thanks to God throughout your day is worship.
Is worship. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Just closing your eyes and thinking about God is worship.
That's right.
It's a necessity in today's world, into a Christian's,
amen,
life, that you worship. So as we read on, as Alex speaks with us, we're going to find out, again, how to worship, and as we read the word.
Amen.
No, Josh, when you looked up the word worship and what said reverence, reverence means deep respect.
Right.
So when we come before the Lord and we worship him, trubutavas respectfully, deviska.
Amen.
But a deep respect.
100%. Amen. God bless you, Willie. Kajaz Angliando Sicharimos, our third scripture is found in Revelations chapter 4, verse 8 through 11. Out of the Good News Bible. Ramogajang. Each one of the four living creatures had six wings, and they were covered with eyes, inside and out. Day and night, they never stopped singing. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is, and who is to come. The four living creatures sing songs of glory and honor and thanks to the one who sits on the throne, who lives forever and ever. When they do so, the elders fall down before the one who sits on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever. They throw their crowns down in front of the throne and say, "Our Lord and God, you are worthy to receive glory, honor, and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were given existence and life."
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's a beautiful scripture.
Amen.
It's just showing you how beautiful God's kingdom is.
Amen.
Having those angels covered in the eyes.
And yes.
Having the, you know, God's glory and power just, amen, shining all over the place. Just, you know, if you close your eyes for a second and just imagine what John is seeing in that revelation. Right. I can only imagine how he felt.
Right.
I'm reading about it and getting chills. And yes. You know, just 100%. Reading about it. Imagine what he felt.
Amen.
Imagine what God showed him. And I thank God that we have that opportunity to read about it, what John saw, because, amen, it was so beautiful. It's showing that, you know, how the angels and, you know, how the elders and how the people were worshiping God.
Amen.
In heaven. Even in heaven, they're worshiping God.
Amen.
That's how it's very important. It's very important. God requires worship. Even the angels,
amen,
are worshiping God.
He created the angels probably to do one thing, Josh, and that was to worship him day, amen, and night.
Amen.
So through the Holy Spirit, it is a Christian's job to be in prayer, to be in worship, constantly. Because without prayer, without worship, a Christian's walk, you think it's hard now, it'll be even harder without those two things.
Amen. 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 God bless you, Alex.
Amen. Jazangli and the Worba, our fourth scripture, is going to be found in Psalms chapter 86, verse 9 and 10 out of the NIV Bible. Ramu Gaja, "All the nations you have made will come and worship before you, Lord. They will bring glory to your name, for you are great and do marvelous deeds. You alone are God."
Amen. Amen. The psalmist here is saying, "All the nations you have made will come and worship before you, Lord. They will bring glory to your name, for you are great and do marvelous deeds. You alone are God." Now, I believe it's David who's saying this.
Yes.
But David had was a great man of God.
Amen.
He had a heart of worship.
Amen.
Tachez, he sought the Lord. He wrote most of the Psalms. If you read, that's right, most of the Psalms, you'll see how David worshiped God.
Yes.
You'll understand how David worshiped God.
Most of it is
worship. Tachez, he did it with great respect up in Al Wali.
Amen.
He did it with fear. He did it with fear that he worshiped God. And it's very it's very beautiful scripture saying that God, he's alone.
Amen.
He's God. He's the one.
That's right.
No other. There's nothing above God.
Amen.
You know, in this scripture, he's, you know, that's his main point, that he is God alone.
Amen.
Amen.
So very, very beautiful scripture. God bless you, Alex.
Josh and Alex, in Psalms 100, verse 2, it says, "Worship the Lord with gladness, come before him with joyful songs." And, amen, look what it says here.
know that the Lord is God.
Amen.
When
Amen.
We come into His presence and we worship Him and we praise Him, not just, gada, okay.
Right.
Done deal. Right. No. We need to go into deep worship
Amen.
And to understand
Amen.
Who God is.
Amen. Amen. And that's what David did here.
Exactly.
That's what David did. He was in deep worship and he realized, Devla, you are God alone.
Amen.
There's nobody that comes after you. You're
there's no one like you.
That's right.
You're amazing. You're so great. And even though he doesn't use those words, that's the feeling he has.
Right.
That's the
expression. Right. Expression.
Exactly. That's the expression he's giving you in the psalm.
Amen.
Very, very beautiful scripture. I mean, as I'm going throughout my day, guys, and you know, I'll go through my phone and I'll read some scriptures, but not that I'm saying that the Bible doesn't speak to me. Right. Psalms speak to me the most.
Amen.
I don't know why, but Amen. I love the way that the psalmist writes. I just love yes. it. It's just beautiful. Some of them are songs, some of them are poems,
right.
some of them are and you know, it's true worship in Psalms.
Amen.
And touch us. They're very beautiful as you read them.
Amen.
Amen.
I believe we have a phone call. Is it Whitey?
No, it's Chris.
Oh.
Chris, you are on the air.
It's
God
the
bless
better
you.
Brother.
Are you
God bless you, Chris. You're on the air.
Just want to say God bless you guys. Good word, Al.
God bless you, better brother.
Worship is a big thing in our lives. And
Amen.
We should always thank God for every opportunity that God's given us. Because such is, like you guys were saying earlier, not that it's easy. Moses saw a sacrifice. It had to have been an unblemished bull or a bird or whatever it was. But
right.
Now we can thank God for every opportunity that it is. So
Amen.
We should worship Him. And like what Joshua was saying was earlier too. To our daily walk, I mean, in everything you can worship God.
That's right.
Being kind, being nice, being joyful, being having, you know, sharing, giving generously. That's worship.
Amen.
And such is, there is power in worship. We know because there's healing, there's joy, there's prosperity.
Amen.
It can even break chains. Paul and Silas was in jail.
That's
and
right.
as they were worshiping, the chains fell off them.
Amen.
So God is more than able to set us free. And we thank God that such is. It's amazing. To worship God, it is an amazing experience.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, Chris.
So I just needed a couple of prayers, guys. For my family, for traveling mercies, Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Thank God for all of our blessings, for our church, pastor, the workers, the servants. I pray that God would keep us strong and anointed to serve Him in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to pray for the city, that God would bless it in Jesus' mighty
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
And I
Amen.
Pray for every young couple that's out there that's seeking a family,
Amen.
That it could be hard for them to pray that prayer. It could be hard to just express what they're feeling and all that. But
Amen. God bless you, Chris.
Able to bless couples.
Amen. Amen. That's a very important prayer in my life. I was one of those couples who were seeking a family, and it was very hard for me to pray that prayer. But the church and, you know, whoever knew that we were seeking that family was praying for me. And after God blessed me, God revealed something to me that it's very important to pray for the other families who are searching for
Amen.
That prayer.
Amen.
And it's very important that we pray for them because it is a blessing, and I pray that God would answer their prayers. It's very tough, and God would give them strength and peace. Let us pray. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Devlo, we acknowledge you, Devlo, for who
yes,
you are,
Lord
Devlo,
Jesus.
King of Kings and Prince of Peace, Devlo. Father
yes,
God,
Lord.
We put, Devlo, the
Thank
city
you,
of Florida, the state of Florida, Devlo, the city of Miami, Devlo, in front of you, Devlo, that you would,
yes,
Father
Lord.
God, pour out your blessings abundantly, Devlo,
Amen.
Unto your,
yes,
unto your churches, Devlo.
Thank
Lord,
you,
Father God,
Devlo.
I pray for Pastor Rooney, Devlo. Devla, Pastor Danny, Devla, that
yes,
you would
Lord.
Bless them, mm-hmm. Devla, that they would continue
Lord.
To do your work, Devla, that you would
you,
continue,
Lord.
Devla, speaking
Amen.
With them, Devla. Lord, Father God, continue to giving them strength, Devla, in their body, Devla. Lord, Father God, I pray, Father God, for the church, Devla, that you would continue using us, Devla.
Yes,
Amen.
Father God, that you would continue to bless us, Father God. I ask,
Lord,
that you continue
Lord.
Blessing,
yes.
Devla, Ronnie Devla, his boys Devla, their yes, wives Devla, that you bless them Devla, all the days of their life Devla, abundantly Devla, that they would always be Devla, the head Devla, never the tail Devla,
yes,
that they would always have Devla, never want Devla.
Thank you,
Lord Father God, I pray this prayer Devla with great expectation Devla for you
yes,
Devla.
Lord,
Lord Father God, I pray Father God for all these prayers Devla that Chris brought up to you Devla, would you be attentive Devla to his prayer Devla and answer them
yes,
Devla quickly Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, Chris.
God bless you, gentlemen. Good words.
Amen.
God bless you, Chris. Good night.
If it's okay, I have a psalm.
Yes.
I have a psalm that I would like to read. It's found in Psalm 73, 25 through 26. And as I was, this was not on purpose. This was not intentional, guys.
Mm-hmm.
As I was studying after Alex gave me the thing, I got some scriptures together, and I didn't go through them quick. I was just... whatever God was revealing to me at the time, I was thinking of words and I was typing them in the concordance, and the scriptures were coming up. And before I know, before I realized it, it was all Psalms. It was all from David.
Yeah.
And as I was saying earlier, if there's anybody to learn how to worship God from, it's David.
Amen. Amen.
So let's read it. Psalm 73, 25 through 26. I believe we have a phone call, but they can wait a second. Whom I have in heaven but you, and earth has nothing I desire besides you. My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever.
Amen.
So what it's saying here is that there's nothing in heaven, there's nothing in earth that our heart desires besides God.
Amen.
That His strength of his heart and he's the portion forever.
Amen.
That he is basically everything to us. There's
Amen.
Nothing, like I said, was saying earlier, there's nothing more than God.
That's
and
right.
And the scripture is just very beautiful, and the way that the psalmist wrote it, you know, saying that there's nothing in heaven, there's nothing on earth
right.
that he desired. And we should have that same desire, guys.
Amen.
Amen.
We should have
Amen.
That same desire to seek God with all our heart.
Amen.
Something we may fail, we may fall, but God is our strength. God is our provider. God is our life.
Amen.
He's touches the our portion forever. I believe we had a phone call, but I believe we lost them. If you would please call back,
back
in, and we will get to your call quickly. We promise. So again, I mean that psalm is just, you know, really spoke to me. It really,
Amen.
It really showed me that there's nothing else.
But God.
But God.
Thank
it
the
just,
Lord.
It brought me to that, you know, that realization that there's nothing else but God.
Amen.
So God bless you guys.
God bless you, Josh. That was very wonderful. Jazz Anglais and the Wordaba. But before Jazz Anglais, Mangaz Daza Mado telephone number, Magdata, area code 954-990-0036. We did have someone named Tony that was calling up, and he got disconnected. If you would, if you're still listening, Tony, please call back, and the phone lines are open right now.
God bless you guys. Wally, do you have anything you'd like to share?
Yeah. Just want to say, Josh, that worship is one of the most important things in my life.
Thank the Lord.
Worship is... I have no words for it.
Amen.
When I come into the presence of God and I feel the presence among us in the church.
Amen. There is no words.
Alex, what a feeling that is.
It's
There's no words for it.
Unbelievable.
I thank God for him giving us the opportunity to come and to worship him.
Amen.
And no matter what we're going through, no matter what we're facing, no matter what the situation may be, true worship, we can get through that.
Amen.
No matter what it may be, we could come before the Lord and lay our requests known unto him. And as we're worshiping, as we're praising him, we get that peace, Alex.
Amen.
That joy in worship.
Amen.
That's why worship is so important to me, because there's just no words for it. It's just, it feels so good when you worship God.
Amen. There is no word for God's presence, Willie.
Amen.
Right. And the pastor shared on this Thursday night, and one of the things he said that is that... The devil has one purpose, is to steal your worship.
That's right.
Exactly.
Because that's what worship does, Wally. That's what worship does to a person. When they're feeling down and out,
right?
When they're feeling depressed, or when they're feeling, you know, ill, mm-hmm. or when they're feeling, you know, weak. If you only would just take the time out and worship God,
Amen.
And I can almost guarantee that He will take that feeling away from you. That's Amen. What worship does. It brings people peace. It brings Amen. People joy. It brings people happiness. It brings people health.
Yes. Amen.
And the devil has one purpose, is to take that worship away from you.
That's right.
So, you know, it's very important that we would, you know, shun the devil and turn away from that, Amen. You know, the evil Amen. That he, you know, and put on the full armor, because it's one, that's another thing in worship, is to, you know, put on the full armor that the devil would, you know, we would be able to resist the devil's schemes and attacks.
Amen.
Guys.
Amen.
Josh, that's the number one thing he wants to take from us.
Amen.
Away right. from us is worship.
Amen.
That's right.
But we thank God because he gave us, like Josh said, the armor to put on the full armor thank of God. Lord. And so we could resist that.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you guys. It's
Amen.
Chaches, I'm getting a lot out of it. I hope the listeners is getting
blessed
a lot out of
it.
Blessed
as we are tonight.
Because, Chaches.
We got about 30 listeners right now.
Oh, do we?
Well, praise the name of the Lord. We God bless each and every one of you guys tuning in.
Amen. We have about 30 listeners. Chaches, Sapinel, Alex, God bless you guys for tuning in. I wish you guys would call in.
Amen.
Our telephone number, 954-990-0036. Again, give a testimony. If you have a prayer request, call in and we'll pray with you.
Amen.
It's very important. Prayer is very important, again, in the Christian's life. It's our worship. It goes hand in hand.
That's right. You can't have one without the other.
Amen. Amen.
And our next scripture is going to be found in, let's see.
The last one you read was Psalms 86:9.
Psalms 86.
But let's get through this phone call.
Yes,
quick.
Yes. God bless you.
We have a caller. Caller, you're on the air.
It's Tony again. I guess I got disconnected.
Hi, Tony. God bless you. Sorry about that, Tony. We had some you know, technical difficulties.
It's
God
okay.
bless you, sir.
No problem.
How are you, Tony?
I'm good. How are you, guys?
We're good. I hope you're being blessed by tonight's message.
I am. You guys are very blessed. I just wanted to call in and say, you know, keep up the good work, guys.
God bless you. Thank you for the part of it.
Amen.
Your guys' generation is truly blessed.
Glory goes to God.
More blessed than the generations before you guys. And I wanted to ask for some prayers. I met a guy, Joe, today. And his son is got cancer. It's pronounced John.
John.
And they're very hurt. They're very lost. I tell them we keep him in prayer. And I'd like if you guys could all lift him up. His name is John. He's got cancer and he's on chemo.
Amen. It's on my heart, guys, that we hold hands and pray for this prayer, because
Amen.
There's power in this
unity.
Prayer. God bless you guys. Heavenly Devla, we come before you, Lord
Jesus.
Yes, Lord we lift
Jesus.
Up John, Devla. Lord, Father God, your name's above all names, Devla.
Yes, more than.
Lord, Father God, cancer may be scary, Devla, to hear, Devla. But, Devla, that's part of this world, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
And, Devla, your son come Jesus have overcame this world,
thank
Father
you,
God.
Thank you,
and you're by your stripes, Devla, he is healed, Devla, from the top
yes,
of his
Lord
head, Devla,
Jesus.
To the soles of his feet, Lord, Father God.
Thank you,
I pray, Devla. Father God, that the next Devla test that they would take, Devla, they would see great results, Devla,
Amen.
From
yes,
you, Devla,
Lord.
And there would be no
complete
more cancer,
healing,
Devla.
Complete
healing,
Jesus
Devla, from
name.
The top of his
pray,
head, Devla, to the soles of his feet, Devla.
Thank
Lord,
you,
Father God, the family may be afraid, Devla, they may be scared, Devla, but Devla, you are the Prince of Peace, Father
thank
God.
You,
Lord, Father God, I pray, Devla, that you would give him peace, Devla, to go
yes.
through this, Devla. Lord, Father
thank
God,
you,
give
Mudel.
John strength, Devla, to overcome, Devla, the fear, Devla.
Yes,
that's not from you, Devla.
Yes,
that's not from you, Devla. You're the God of comfort, Devla. You're the God
thank
of peace,
you,
Devla. And the devil, Devla, is probably trying to attack them, Devla. But I pray, Devla, that you would clothe them, Devla, Chaches, Devla,
yes,
with your
Devla.
Full
yes,
armor,
Jesus.
Devla. That they
protect
would resist
Jesus.
The devil's Mudel. Attack, Devla. And that
thank
they would defeat
you,
him, Devla, with your word, Devla.
Yes,
Lord,
Mudel.
Father God, I pray this prayer, Devla, and great expectation, Devla, for great things to come for this family, Devla. And I know healing
in
is
Jesus
on its way for
mighty
John.
Name,
yes,
Devla,
Lord.
We pray.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
God bless
Amen.
You, Tony.
God bless you guys. Keep up the good work. Fight the good fight. Run the good race, guys.
Amen.
God bless
God
you.
God bless you.
God bless you. Good night.
Did you find your scripture?
Yes.
Okay.
This is our final scripture, and it is found in Revelations chapter 1, verse 14 through 16, read out of the Good News Bible. And it's a little bit of reading, but verse 14, Ramo Gajan. His hair was white as wool or as snow, and his eyes blazed like fire. His feet shone like brass that has been refined and polished, and his voice sounded like a roaring waterfall. He held 7 stars in his right hand, and a sharp 2-edged sword came out of his mouth. His face was as bright as the midday sun. What an awesome God Amen. We serve. Amen?
Amen.
Leskabal, they are as white as snow, Penelamingi Bible. Vi leska pura, Stefan, like brass that was put in a fire and polished. His eyes, Penel, his everything about the Lord, Nasti di Kuspeleste, he says he shined like the midday sun. Could you actually sit there and look at the sun? It's impossible. No. That's what kind of glory God has. That's Amen. What kind of holy God we serve. Nasti even di kazleski gloria. That's why nasti arasas kaileski gloria. Amen. The only thing that happens is that through Christ Jesus, we are able to praise the name of God.
Amen. Amen. I just want to say one thing. I don't know why this is coming to me, but we may look at Jesus. We never really saw Jesus.
Amen.
If it wasn't for, you know, Passion of the Christ or right. Jesus of Nazareth exactly. or those, you know, movies, we never actually saw Jesus. But that's that's what we think he looks like.
Amen.
As we see in the shows.
Okay? Right.
But that's not what he looks like. Right. What it says in that scripture is
what he looks like.
That's how awesome and how powerful and Amen. How wonderful Amen. And how beautiful Amen. God is. His hair is white as snow. His feet are like bronze. Amen. His voice is like rushing waters. He holds 7 stars.
In Amen.
His hand. Look
Amen.
Look how big his hand is.
To hold 7 stars in his hands.
We look at the stars and, you know, maybe I'm not getting off subject, but it may sound like I'm getting off subject. We may look at a star and it looks so small, but you know right. how big that it's a planet.
Exactly. It's a planet. Enormous.
And God holds 7 in his hand.
Amen.
He is a mighty sword, God. There's a sword coming out of his mouth.
That is, amen.
It's so wonderful and so great. And that's who God is.
Amen.
Listener, that's who you worship.
Amen.
That's who you worship.
Amen.
You worship an almighty God.
An awesome God.
And a great God.
Amen.
There's no words Thank you, for Jesus. It. There's no words for it. And, you know, we might be a little bit afraid and saying, well, how can I worship God?
Right.
As I was saying earlier, we don't sing. I can't sing. I'm off tune. I can't stay on melody. That's not the only way to worship, guys.
That's right.
Josh. Odele is not looking for a good voice or
Amen.
Just any voice. Amen. He's looking for the heart,
Amen.
The true heart
I'm
of
glad
worship.
I'm glad you said that because I was supposed to say that and it slipped my mind, but I'm glad you brought up that
Amen.
Point. He's not looking for a song. He's looking for a heart. He's looking for somebody who's looking to worship him in spirit and truth, a heart of worship. He's not looking for a song.
Amen.
And Josh, it's not only just worship too. It's about having that relationship.
Mm.
With God in worship.
Amen.
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 Amen. God
that's
bless
what
you.
He's looking for. He's looking,
so he's looking for
a relationship with you. And that's another, you know, part of worship has having
that's
a
right.
relationship Amen. With God. You have anything else to say? Because
no.
I wanted to. Okay.
No, go ahead.
I wanted to read some other ways to worship. As I was saying, you know, you may be thinking to yourself, I'm not a choir. I'm not a pastor. I'm not a teacher. I'm not this. I'm not that. But you are who you are, and God made you who you are.
That's right.
And Amen. You're able to worship. You may be saying to yourself, well, it's so hard to worship. It's not easy.
Right.
No, it may seem hard, but it's not hard. It's very easy to worship God. And like Amen. It says in that psalm I read earlier, it's a necessity to worship God.
Yes.
And here's here's 5 points on how to worship God. True prayer.
Amen.
Just speaking to him.
Amen.
You know, and acknowledging him.
Amen.
In Matthew, the disciples are asking God, How do we pray? How do we pray, Lord? And Jesus says, just say these simple words. He tells them how to pray. But the first words that he says is, Our Father, who is in heaven,
Amen.
Hallowed be your name. Amen. What that means is holy. You are holy.
Amen.
You are holy.
Amen. Thank
Father, who is in heaven, holy be your name.
Thank you, Lord.
And just that acknowledgement alone, just, you know, lifting up the, you know, the Lord's name is worship.
Amen.
It's worship.
Amen.
I believe we have a phone call. Before we read the other points, we're going to go to this phone call. I believe it's Jerry. Jerry, you're on the air. Jerry, you're on the air.
Hi, guys. God bless you guys.
God bless you, Whitey.
God bless you.
Guys, I just wanted to comment real fast on what we're talking about.
God bless you.
God bless you guys. God bless you guys for the word. This is a great subject, and I think anybody could get involved with.
Amen. Amen.
Because
thank the Lord.
It's something to be joyful about, something to be happy and excited about. God's worship, what he deserves from all of us.
Amen.
Beautiful scripture that you read, Alex.
Thank the Lord.
That's the image of God. That's Amen. Who you're serving. Amen.
Amen.
That's who God is.
Amen.
That's right. I mean, just the look of that is amazing, right?
Amen.
But the Bible says, you know, that when Jesus was on earth, you know, he didn't have nothing attractive about him to attract him to man. He wasn't a super handsome guy. He wasn't anything special about him or had a divine look.
Right.
He just had a normal look.
Right.
Why did those two things go hand in hand?
Mm.
It's because the man, what he said, what he taught, his words, who he was inside, reflects that image.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. Great point.
And goes hand in hand. So what his words inspire, the same awe. Who he is inside inspires the same awe as who he is outside. And the outside is just to show that to the eye. But what he is, who he is, even his words, even who he is as a being, not a human being, but a being, a God.
Amen. Amen.
As you say that scripture, that scripture comes in mind as he was teaching in the synagogue, and I don't know how old was he. He was a young man, I believe, in this time of the ministry, and he was preaching the word.
Yeah.
And the Pharisees and the priests were saying, "Where does this wisdom? Where does this teaching? Where does this come from?"
Right.
And that's what we're seeing in this scripture in Revelation. That's what John saw. What he's up in that too. He saw, you know, a great image of God. And like I said earlier, maybe we see him in the movies, but that's not who God was. God wasn't Mel Gibson. He wasn't Mel Gibson.
Right.
He wasn't attracted Bible, but that's what attracted people to him, his great wisdom and knowledge in those words. And glory goes to God. God is he looks great now in heaven.
Amen.
He looks great now in heaven. God bless you.
Was the inward light that he was able to show on earth, and that's now reflected in the image shown in Revelation. So
Amen.
whether you see God's glory or not, you're still able to worship him. He's still deserving of glory and praise because of who he is.
Amen.
The image just reflects who he is inside, and that's what's allows you to worship him no matter what. That's what separates him from just, you know, an idol or something that devoted to your time, something that is important to you. God is real. God is
Amen.
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 God is powerful, and he backs it up with who he is.
That's right.
And like you guys have been saying, that image shows who he is.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory goes to God. Thank you,
Jesus. God bless you guys. Now I got a couple of prayers. I don't think it's long. I want to pray for, of course, my father, my uncle, Traveling Mercies, my cousins, Amen. Traveling Amen. Mercies. Also, I want to pray specifically for me and my brother for healing of physical problems, that the Lord would just remove it from our lives.
Amen.
Amen.
Also, specific prayer for our ministry, that the Lord would bless all these ministries, that we would continue to be on fire for him, and that the Lord would grow his ministry for the home and all his people.
Amen.
Amen. All right, let us pray, Whitey.
Mugodad, we thank you, Father.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Lord, we pray for Whitey and his family, Mugodad.
Thank you, Mugodad.
We thank you for them, Mugodad. We thank you, Mugodil, because you are a blessed people, Mugodil. Lord, Father God, we pray for Chris and Whitey, Mugodad, and we put them in front of you, Father. Lord, and I pray, Mugodad, that you would heal them, Mugodad, completely, Mugodad. Whatever the problem may be, Father, we put it in front of you, Mugodad. Sastadli, Mugodad. Sastadli, Gostato, Mugodil.
Amen, Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus, Father. Lord, we pray, Mugodad, for whatever Whitey prayed for, Mugodad, and we put it in front of you, Mugodad.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Lord, Father, you know, Mugodad, our needs, Father. You know our problems, Mugodad. And Lord, we thank you, Mugodad, because you are there for us all the time, Mugodad. Lord, we pray for our church, Mugodad, for our ministry, Mugodad. And Lord, we pray for all the churches, Mugodil, that you would bless them, Father.
Yes, Mugodil.
Lord, I pray, Mugodad, that your Holy Spirit would always take over into that place, Mugodad. Amen. Lord, we thank you for everything, Father. We worship you and we praise you. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 Amen. God bless you, Whitey.
A great word. Keep it up.
God bless you, Whitey.
God bless you.
Wish you were here, buddy.
Amen.
Okay, so as I left off, other ways to worship. The first one I mentioned was true prayer.
Yes.
Just acknowledging God for who he is.
Amen.
You know, just, you know, realizing that he is holy. He's God.
Amen.
That's a part of prayer. Another way to worship, and this is something I'm working on now.
Mm.
The listener may think, oh, well, these guys know a lot. We don't. We don't know a lot
Amen.
About the Bible.
Amen.
This is something God is doing in our lives now.
Amen.
Right.
We've been praying that God would use us young men to teach the Word of God and to share it with people.
Amen.
And I thank God for this opportunity, Chachez. And this is something I'm working on now, is getting a regular habit of reading the Bible. That's
yes.
another way of worship.
Yes.
Just
yes.
Reading your Bible, seeing what God did for, you know, people.
Amen.
Reading stories, you know, and just getting fed, because the Word of God is living.
Amen.
The Bible is living.
Yes.
Amen.
A while ago back, I heard Gajo say that when he reads the Bible, the letters move.
Wow.
And what is he talking about, right? And he said, no, the word is, the Bible is real. The Bible is living.
Amen.
And he's, you know, he's seen his life flash before his eyes, and God revealed to him things. And I experienced that same thing a few days ago. And, you know, God revealed to me something, and I realized what the Gajo meant, that the Bible is living.
Amen.
And that's another way of worshiping God. So everybody has a Bible in their house.
That's right.
You may not have a great voice, but you, like I said earlier, you don't have to sing. There's other ways to worship.
That's
and
right.
The first one was prayer. The second one was reading your Bible.
Amen.
The third one is obeying God.
Yes.
Obeying God is very important.
Very important.
That's another way of worshiping. That you would, you know, when you hear God's voice and God tells you to do something, Wally, Alex, Justin, that you would, if God says, okay, go pray for that person, okay, and you can't pray for that person at that specific time, that you would remind yourself that you would go pray with that person. Because that's a
that's
big
right.
part of worship, to do God's will. And if God
that's
tells
right.
you to do something, I encourage you to do that, because
Amen.
it's a blessing. When God talks to you and tells you, go pray with that person, give that person money, you know,
Amen.
You know,
Amen.
Help that person out any 100%. Way you can. That's another way of worshiping.
Amen.
Amen.
And obeying God. It's a great
Amen.
Way of worship.
Amen.
Let's go for a phone call. Oh, we have a phone call. Yeah. I'm sorry. Caller, you're on the air.
Hi, Ronnie. Hi, guys. How everybody out there?
Good. God bless you. Juan-san.
Eddie Bunzels.
Oh, hi, Uncle Eddie. How are you?
Pretty good. Hey, I wanted you guys to pray for my mother. She's been in intensive care, and she's coming out, and I wanted you guys to give us a prayer for a quick healing.
No problem.
Amen.
To come out on Monday.
No
you
problem.
Guys give us a little prayer for that.
No problem, sir. God bless you and your family.
You
Heavenly
too.
Father, Devla, we acknowledge you, Devla, for who you are, Devla.
Yes,
King
Lord.
Of kings, Devla, yes. Lord of lords, Devla. Lord, Father God, in Isaiah, Devla, it says, Devla, that by your stripes, Devla, we are
Thank
healed,
you,
Devla. And I pray, Father God,
yes.
for our sister, Devla, and Christ, Devla, that you would heal her, Devla, from the top of her head, Devla, to the soles of her feet, Devla. That you, Father God, would take her out of intensive care, Devla, and bring her, Devla, to the comfort of her home, Devla, soon, Devla. Heal,
in Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name, Devla. Lord, Father God, any and his family are praying and hoping that you would come home Monday, Devla.
Yeah.
I pray that prayer, Devla, with them, Devla. I agree with
Jesus
them that she will come
name,
home
Devla.
Monday, Devla. Lord, Father God, I stand in agreement, Devla, with our brother,
will.
Devla, and Christ, Devla, and we wait on great expectation, Devla, for good things to come, Devla, for his mother, Devla, and his family, Devla. Lord, Father God, I pray for Alan, Devla, and Nido, Devla, and Isaac, Devla, and their family, Devla. I pray that you bless them, Devla, abundantly, Devla, that they would continue, Devla, their family would continue, Devla, to do the work, Devla, that you would provide every need, Devla, for them,
Lord.
In Jesus' name, Devla, we pray. Amen. God bless you, Uncle Eddie.
And one more safe trip for Fat Frank.
Yes. Heavenly Father, Devla, we pray for Uncle Frankie, Devla, and Bibi Sylvia, Devla, and Ronnie, Devla. Lord, Father God, they're on the road, Devla, coming here to Miami, Devla. I pray, Devla, traveling mercy, Devla, that your head of protection, Devla, would be surrounded, Devla, as they drive down here, Devla, for your glory, Devla. We know, Devla, that you have great things to come for and here in Florida, Devla. Healing, Devla.
Thank you.
Spiritual blessings, Devla. Financial blessings.
Lord.
All these things, Devla, from you, Lord, Father God.
Jesus.
Would you bless them, Devla, as they come here, Devla, to worship you, Devla? In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you, Mordo.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, Uncle Eddie.
Well, God bless you guys, and God bless Miami Church.
God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Okay, so we have two other ways to worship. There's a lot of other
ways.
But
of
these
course.
Are a few things that came to me in mind.
Amen.
Building deeper relationships with other Christians.
Yes.
It's very important to
fellowship.
You know, fellowship with other people.
Amen.
And not only things, you know, we may not say we're not all evangelists.
Right.
You know, we can't go out there and minister the word of God. If you know the word of God, if God speaks with you and you're
Amen.
A Christian, you know the word of God.
That's right.
You're able to go out there and save souls. You're
That's
able
right.
to do the work of God. God has called you.
Amen.
He gave us the ability
Amen.
To do that.
For a reason, and that's to go out there and to win souls for him.
Amen.
And that's
ambassadors
another,
for God.
And that's another act of worship.
Amen.
To fellowship with other people and to call people to Christ.
Amen.
This is something that maybe we don't want to hear, but tithing.
Yes.
Tithing
big
is
part
a
of worship.
Big part of worship. It may not seem so, but it's a big part of worship. And I'm just going to read something here. Agajo wrote this, and as I was reading it, it really meant something to me. If you want to know what in your life... no, let me read that again. If you want to know what in your life you worship, look at your checkbook registers. The Bible teaches us this important lesson. For where your treasure is, there your heart will also. God wants us to surrender our entire being to him. One way to show that is making him Lord of our pocketbook.
Mm.
If you are already a committed tither, consider raising this percentage you are willing to give. Okay? So if you're not a tither, we pray that you would be encouraged to become a tither.
To start to become
right,
a tither. Amen.
Because it's a very important thing in Christian's walk and worship that you would become a tither. And if
Amen.
You are a tither, I pray that you would raise up the percentage. If you give 10%, it's a necessity to give 10%.
Yes.
But if you know, if God says give 11%, 12%, Amen. 13%, 14%,
20%,
whatever God
puts on
your
heart.
Your heart, give it.
Amen.
It's a great part of worship. We only have a few minutes left in the program, but if you want to call in, our telephone number 954-990-0036, 954-990-0036. So that's other ways to worship. Like
Amen.
I said earlier, you don't have to be in church. You don't have to be you know, at a specific place. You can worship God anywhere. And these are other ways to worship. I know Wally wants to say something, but real quick, worship through prayer, worship through reading your Bible, obey God, tithe, and speaking with, you know, non-Christians and fellowship with other Christians.
Amen.
Great ways to start worshiping God.
Wally. Amen.
Amen. God bless you, Josh. Good point. Josh, I'm going back to John, where Jesus talks with the Samaritan woman. It says in John 4:23. Yet, a time is coming and has now come when the true worshipers will
Amen.
Worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
For they are the kind of worshipers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and his worshipers must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
Alex, when we come before the Lord and we worship, it's not just supposed to be, all right, just let me worship.
Right.
You understand? Thank it's you, just Devlon. A thing. Right. No. We need to worship him in spirit and in truth.
Sailisa.
Because that's the kind of worshiper he's looking for.
Amen.
Alex, I hate to say this, but if anyone don't worship in spirit and truth, it's not pleasing to God.
Amen.
It's not.
Nope. Amen.
So we have to be in spirit and in truth. And all the things Josh said in tithing, in prayer, and going out there, we all have to be in spirit and truth doing this. Mm-hmm. Because that's the kind of worship the Father seeks in Amen. Spirit and in truth.
Right. Amen.
We could do anything, Vada Sadwali.
Exactly.
We can read the Bible and it'll just be a normal book.
Right.
Exactly.
We can pray and it'll just be like talking to the air. We can, you know, not mean it.
That's right.
You know?
That's right.
We can tithe and do it with a grudging heart, and it doesn't mean nothing.
It doesn't mean nothing.
You're just giving anything. Your money to church. If
That's
you're doing
right.
That. You're not blessing God.
That's right.
You know, you could, you know, speak with somebody and turn around and, you know, talk behind their back.
Mm.
That doesn't do that. You have to do all these things in spirit and truth.
Spirit and truth.
I believe we have a phone call. Caller, you're on the air.
Hello, Joel.
BB Sally?
Yeah.
How are you?
Hey, who am I talking to?
Joshua.
Hey, Joshua. God bless you, my son.
God bless you, too.
I'm just so happy. To hear you young guys on the radio.
Glory goes to God.
Amen.
God.
Amen.
It's just beautiful.
God, glory goes to God. God bless you. God bless you for the encouragement. Chachez.
God bless you. And put a prayer in for our church, for pastor, for you guys, for your fathers, for your mothers, for everybody in Jesus' name.
God bless you. We're going to pray for you too. Alex?
Amen. Let us bring this before the Lord. Amen. Mordel, we give you glory, praise, and honor, Mordel, in Christ Jesus' name, Devla. We thank you, Mordel, for BB Sally, Mordel. Devla, we ask, Mordel, that you uplift her, Mordel, in spirit and in truth, Mordel. That you bless her, Mordel, all the days of her life, Mordel. So godi san de la kogujimos, Mordel. So godi supi la koilo, Mordel. Tu janes, Devla, Jesus. Mordel, pintele feresti andau gaio, Mordel. I short pelate o blessing, Mordel, kai sola, chia shila, Mordel. In Christ Jesus' name, Devla, we pray, Mordel, for the pastor, Mordel, tehara, Mordel.
Amen.
Mordel, we ask you, Mordel, right now, Devla, as he's studying, Mordel, for your word, Mordel. Pintar, Mordel, efedestian daugayo, Mordel, and pour out, Mordel, your blessing on the pasture right now in the name of Jesus, Mordel. Fill him, Mordel, with spiritual wisdom and knowledge, Mordel.
Yes,
Father. Minister to him, Mordel, that way he can minister to your people tomorrow, Mordel. In Christ Jesus' name, because he is your ambassador, Mordel, to your people, Mordel. Angatuti, Mordel, in Christ Jesus' name, Devla, we pray, Mordel. We give you all glory, praise, and honor, Mordel. Thank you, Mordel, for this radio station, Mordel, because it is truly a blessing from you, Mordel. Devla, we ask, Mordel, that you bless everyone who is listening, Mordel. That it be, Mordel, glory to you, Mordel, as we all continue to worship you, Mordel. Let us seek you, Mordel, earnestly, Sadapinilki Warba, Mordel, in spirit and in truth, Mordel. Let us all be closer to you, Mordel, and have greater worship, Mordel,
yes,
with
Lord.
You. May, Mordel, Sade Prakai Samkate, Mordel, Haikongodi Ashunela, Mordel. In Christ Jesus' name, Devla, grant us that prayer, Mordel. In the name of Jesus, we pray. We give you all glory, praise, and honor, Mordel, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. This is so beautiful. You're the third generation that I'm listening to and having in church. This is beautiful.
Glory goes to God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Love you guys. God
Love
bless.
You
God, God bless. Bless you.
God bless you too.
Bye.
So, as I was saying, there's a lot of ways to worship.
Amen.
And, you guys had anything else to say? Well, that was our program.
Amen.
And
Glory goes to God.
God bless you guys for listening. God bless Amen. You guys for calling in. God bless you guys for, you know, calling in with you guys' prayers. And thank you guys for the encouragement, Chachez.
Amen.
It's
truly a blessing
truly
to serve
blessing
the Lord.
Amen.
Chachez, to serve the Lord. And Chachez, we're not doing this for any other reason but to bring God glory.
Amen.
We're not doing it for ourselves. You know, we're not doing it for anything else. And I I just want to let everybody know who's listening that we're doing it for God.
Amen.
And we thank you guys for bearing with us and listening to us.
Amen.
God bless you guys for calling in. Tomorrow we have a church service. We start at 4:15.
Amen.
If you walk in about 4:30, you should be fine. 7200 Davie Road Extension, and we're in Hollywood, Florida. We encourage you guys to come in tomorrow.
Amen.
You have something to say?
Yeah, Josh, whoever is listening, I just want to encourage you guys to go to your church tomorrow.
Amen.
If you're in the Miami area, come to the Miami church.
Amen.
If you're out of town, go to your church. And the subject tonight is about worship. Tomorrow, go to your Father's house and worship Him in Amen. Spirit and in truth.
Amen.
No matter what you may be facing,
Amen.
True worship, you will get through it.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thursday night we have a service. We try to start at 9:30, but you know, 10 o'clock you guys should be fine. Again at the church, 7200 Davie Road Extension, Hollywood, Florida.
Amen.
We encourage you guys to come. Last Thursday we was very low on attendance, and I prayed. You guys are missing out.
Amen.
Last Thursday
Amen.
Was one of the best services I experienced.
Thursday was Amen. Amazing.
Amazing.
I've been serving in this church for 13 years, and last Thursday was one of the best services. Touches God was there himself.
Yes, thank the
himself.
Lord.
Himself, God was there. I felt thank his presence. And if you guys wasn't there, you guys missed out. Amen. So if you guys want to come back.
Don't miss out tomorrow, Miami. Join us tomorrow, 4:15, 7200 Davie Road Extension, Hollywood, Florida. Come and worship and be blessed by the best. Amen.
Hallelujah.
From all of us at Kingdom of God Ministries, we say God bless you and good night.
God bless you guys.
Stay classy, Miami.
Stay classy.